Steam Summer Sale dates have been leaked. More free games from Epic Games may have been also leaked. Mafia Definitive Edition will be a part of Mafia Trilogy and so much more. It's a leak fest and we got some more things to talk about in this very episode of Top Gaming News. My name is Gavin Manis and let's just jump right into it. Let's start off with some exciting news because it seems like Steam Summer Sales dates have been leaked. It seems like a routine every year where the dates have been leaked and then Valve is like, I don't know what's happening. And then the Steam Summer Sale do happen and then the whole store just crashes. Anyway, it is found that the Steam Summer Sale is happening from June 25th to July 9th. This leak came from Steam Database, which occasionally leaks whatever is happening in Steam or whatever is coming to Steam. Pavel, one of the minds behind Steam Database, have been saying that Steam is working on a loyalty point where you can earn various amount of things, such as Steam badges, digital items, or maybe discount to some games. Steam Summer Sale is one of those days when you buy so many games, or maybe some games, because most of the titles go on sale at very good prices, except the new ones, which will have a 10% discount or maybe no discount at all. I'm pretty much sure that WWE 2K19 will still cost 3K rupees. Yeah, it's only me who's checking out the price of WWE 2K19 in Steam store page. What other games are you going to buy from Steam sale? Let me know in the comments below. And you know, it's actually a good thing that the Steam sale is happening from July end, because apparently Epic is still wanting to deliver some more free games. Now, as I said, that Epic Games are releasing free games, and that's right, because last week, it was the first time that Epic Store actually crashed, because they released a game for free, which is GTA 5. Of course, a game that huge, everybody will be like... People went insane with the fact that the store page is crashing, and for some people, the game was not even installing. And soon enough, they did fix it up, and now you can get the game peacefully, without any issues. But that is not the only game that Epic is going to release for free, because there are more games coming and it seems like those games have also been leaked. A Reddit leak shows an image that says that Epic will be releasing all these games for free. And those are Civilization 6 on May 21st, Borderlands The Handsome Collection on May 28th and Ark Survival Evolved on June 4th. Now, just so you know, these are leaks and not confirmed news, so it might be very possible that someone is playing prank with us. And these games might change when the dates do come around. So we have to wait to see if this is actually happening when May 21st comes around. Because a lot of people are also speculating that Witcher 3 will be the next free game. I mean, yeah, putting out GTA 5 for free, that's a big game. But having Witcher 3 on the side as free? That is too big. Well, Epic doesn't stop here, because Epic also have a mega sale happening on the store page where you can buy Control for only $11. Control is one of the best games that released last year from Remedy Games, and speaking of Remedy Games, it seems like Alan Wake has made a comeback to Steam with only 42 rupees. So if you have never checked out the world of Alan Wake, which somehow inspired Control as well, then check it out right now, because now is the time that you can actually play Alan Wake. Now, last week we saw the Unreal Engine 5 tech demo, which runs film quality assets without any issues, where it can render models with millions and millions of polygons without any issues. With the help of Unreal Engine 5, everything will be loaded very quickly, instead of just popping out as we close into that object, as we are used to that in various other games. The idea behind this is to render out an approximation of the object, which is having high quality and high polygon count, and also not to lose that detail. With Unreal Engine 5, if you have models made from, let's say, ZBrush, which is a great tool to sculpt models with high polygon counts, you can just use those models in Unreal Engine 5 and it will just work. You don't have to work even more to make those models accessible in the engine, because it will be just used just like that. Now, of course, to see this much detail in your gameplay, you will need a better PC. That means a better GPU and a better CPU and also a much better SSD. It has also been told that in order to have the perfect performance, you can also go for a PC full with SSDs. Now, the reason behind SSDs is not only to load the games faster, but also to load assets and textures and models in the fastest way possible without losing any kind of detail. Now, this doesn't mean that you cannot do this with HDD, because you can also get a good performance with HDD, but you will just have lower quality. The CEO of Epic Games has said that PS5 architecture of SSD is god tier and pretty far ahead of that of PCs. But with NVMe SSDs, you can still get an awesome performance. Now, I have no idea why it was compared to PS5 SSDs being a god tier and pretty far ahead than PCs, but only time will tell if this will actually happen. With this new Unreal Engine 5, lighting has improved a lot as they have introduced Luma, which is a particle system that can mimic the behavior of bat swarms and roaches. Physics system has improved a lot more, and so much more has been added to Unreal Engine 5. Now, of course, the question arises, will we get the exact same performance when the developers are gonna make games in Unreal Engine 5? Of course, the tech demo looks amazing, but it's one thing to see a tech demo, it's another thing to see a gameplay from a game developer using Unreal Engine 5 to make their game. What do you think about this tech demo? Let me know in the comments below. Are you excited that the games have come this far with textures and lighting and make it more photorealistic than it was few years back? Assassin's Creed Valhalla, still highly anticipated game, even though the gameplay trailer was not so good, but people are having strong hopes that this game will actually do good. Now, over the course of years, Assassin's Creed have changed a lot of things. They have removed the hidden blade, they have changed the environment, and they have just gone to a much older time in general. Man, I almost thought that we will get an Assassin's Creed of 21st century. Opportunity missed right there. The creative director of Valhalla has now recently told that the effectiveness of Hidden Blade will be restored in the game because this game will be focused on stealth-based gameplay. Not that previous Assassin's Creed game didn't have stealth-based gameplay, but since we have a Hidden Blade, we will definitely have more effectiveness of that Hidden Blade with that stealth gameplay. The creative director told that Ivar, the protagonist, will get this Hidden Blade, but he is more of a Viking and doesn't know the exact use of Hidden Blade. But as the game progresses, he will learn more and more, and soon enough, you can even one-shot kill anyone with the right timing. Now, this is a skill that you will have to learn as the game progresses, unlike other Assassin's Creed game where you just had the Hidden Blade and you just know how to use it. During Ubisoft Forward, which is Ubisoft's digital event, the creative director has told that there will be more of Assassin's Creed Valhalla than what was shown in Xbox event. And he knows that the gameplay trailer was not satisfying enough. So I hope that in Ubisoft Forward, things might change. Maybe during that event, we might even see a gameplay after all. Maybe it was the plan of Ubisoft to show that gameplay trailer in the Xbox event and then show the actual gameplay in the Ubisoft event. Well, we have to wait till July 21st because that's when Ubisoft Forward is happening. Now, last week, 2K Games revealed the comeback of their biggest franchise, Mafia Trilogy, which is a trilogy that we don't really know. Now, of course, it says trilogy, which obviously means all the Mafia games being remastered. Even though Mafia 3 still looks good, and I don't know if a remaster is even needed, because to be honest, the game looks just fine. But we have to wait till tomorrow, because tomorrow is the day when they will actually reveal what this trilogy is all about. The teaser did show scenes from Mafia 2 and 3, but not from Mafia 1, so not so sure what's happening exactly here. Now, shortly after this news came out, Mafia Definitive Edition appeared on Microsoft's store page, and now it has been removed. And when it was up on Microsoft Store, it had some pretty good screenshots, which obviously says that the game is a remaster. Now, it seems like the Definitive Edition is faithful recreation of the game with expanded story and original score. So that's good. It also reveals that Mafia 2 and 3 Definitive Edition are also on the way. Looks like this is what that Mafia trilogy is all about. I still cannot get over the fact that they are remastering Mafia 3. Maybe it's just me who still thinks that it is comparatively new. What are your thoughts about Mafia games? Have you guys played any of the Mafia game? Which one stands as your favorite? Let me know all of that in the comments below. Halo Infinite will be an Xbox Series launch game, but ever since that trailer, we have seen nothing about that game. But it was told that Xbox would showcase first-party games in their next Xbox event coming on July. Now, obviously, that means Halo Infinite might be one of those first-party games, but it was never confirmed until now, because now it has been confirmed that Halo Infinite is one of those first-party games and it will be shown in that next presentation in July. The developer 343 Industries confirmed this news by saying in a post that it is coming in the next Xbox presentation that's happening on July. Now, this is very much possible that they will be revealing a gameplay video for Halo Infinite. Or it can be just like Ubisoft where they would release a gameplay trailer of it. But if they actually show the gameplay video, that would be great for everyone. People will be happy in both the ends. Now, we don't have a specific date about this event of Xbox that's happening on July, so we have to wait when that happens. But I'm actually excited to see this Xbox presentation because I believe somehow that there is more new things coming in this presentation that we don't know about. Halo Infinite is coming to Xbox and PC by the end of 2020. Maybe in July, we will get to know when the release date is. Since E3 happens in June and July, a lot more things are gonna happen. Maybe new game announcements, maybe new discounts, maybe more free games, and so much more. So do subscribe to Gamer Connect if you haven't already to get to know everything that is happening in the gaming world. And also follow us on all social media platforms to get to know what is happening in Gamer Connect and much more events that Gamer Connect will host in the future. Do not forget to hit that like button and comment down below what you think about anything that we just discussed in this episode of Top Gaming News. My name is Gin Manus, and I will see you guys in another video. Bye-bye.